Order of operations. Order of operations are a set of rules that we use to determine which operations or procedures we do in order to evaluate expressions. We always work from left to right. And the order of operations are parentheses or brackets, exponents, multiplication or division from left to right, whichever comes first, and then addition and subtraction from left to right, whichever comes first. So if we're asked to evaluate this expression using the order of operations, each time we want to write out our parentheses, exponents, multiplication or division, addition or subtraction. Okay, that spells the word PEMDAS. So you'll commonly see that written as PEMDAS. There's some other versions, but we're going to use PEMDAS. So each time we're asked to evaluate, I'm looking for parentheses. There's no parentheses, so I'll check that one. I look for exponents. There's no exponents. Okay, now I'm looking for multiplication or division. And yes, I have multiplication, so I'm going to do that first. 4 times 2 is 8. Whatever else I bring straight down. Okay, so I've taken care of my multiplication or division. And now I have addition or subtraction, and I do have addition, so I'm going to add those two and get 14. Okay, so I've used my order of operations, and I've evaluated the expression, and I've come up with an answer of 14. Okay, in this problem, again, we start out using the order of operations to evaluate the expression. We're looking for parentheses. There's no parentheses. Now we're looking for exponents. There's no exponents. Multiplication or division? Yes. Okay, so we're working from left to right, whichever comes first. And if I look carefully, I see that division comes, I have division and I have multiplication, but division comes first from left to right, so I'll do that first. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. Everything else will come straight down. Okay, now again, I've done division, now I have multiplication. So 3 times 4 is 12. I'll bring everything else straight down. Okay, so now I have addition and subtraction, and I'm going to work from left to right. So when I start from left to right, addition is first, so I'll do that first. 2 plus 12 is 14, minus 8. Okay, and now I'll subtract 14 minus 8, and I'll get 6. So I've covered all my order of operation has been covered and completed. Okay, let's do some more. Okay, I'm going to evaluate this expression using the order of operations again. So first thing I'm looking for is parentheses or brackets. In this case, I do have parentheses, so I'm going to do that first. So 5 plus 7 is 12. I'm going to bring everything else straight down. Okay, now, next thing I'm looking for is exponents. There's no exponents. Multiplication or division from left to right, whichever comes first. So I have, in this case I have multiplication, I do have division, but multiplication comes first. So I'm going to multiply 3 times 12 and get 36. And bring everything else down. Alright, so now, I have division, so I'll do that next. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. I have 36 minus 3 is 33. So once I got my division, then I'm looking for addition or subtraction. I had subtraction, and I took care of that. There was no addition, so my orders of operation have been completed and done in the correct order, and my simplified evaluated answer was 33. Okay, this problem, I'm looking for parentheses. I do have parentheses. So 6 times 4 is 24. I'll bring everything else down. Now, there's no exponents. There's no multiplication or division. But I do have addition and subtraction. Again, I'm working from left to right with addition or subtraction, whichever comes first. In this case, subtraction comes first, so I'll do it first. 124 minus 24 is 100, and I have plus 31. Okay, so I've covered that. Now I'll do my addition, and I have 131 as my simplified evaluated answer. Okay, how about one that's a little bit tougher? Okay, so again, we're going to evaluate using the order of operations. So I'm looking for parentheses. I do have parentheses, so I'm going to start there. Now, inside out. So inside the parentheses, I have exponents. I need to do that first. So I'm going to keep my parentheses, but I'm going to do my exponents. So 10 squared, or 10 to the second power, is 10 times 10, and that's 100. And I have minus 19. Everything else is going to come straight down. Okay, so I still have parentheses. I'm still working at that step. So 100 minus 19 is 81. Okay. So now I have eliminated my parentheses. I did my exponents earlier, so they're taken care of inside the parentheses. So now I have multiplication or division. I'm looking for that. I have division, I have multiplication. Again, I'm working from left to right. So I'm going to do division first. 81 divided by 3 is 27. Everything else will come straight down. Division is taken care of. Now, multiplication, I do have multiplication, so 27 times 2 is 54. I have 55, I'm going to bring that straight down. And 55 minus 54 is 1. So, it was, took care of multiplication, we did addition, we had no addition, so, and we had subtraction. Again, we work from left to right with multiplication or division, addition or subtraction, left to right, and our final answer was 1. Okay, here's our final challenge problem. And in this example, we have not only parentheses, we also have brackets. So we want to go from inside out on brackets. So we want to do our parentheses, which are inside the brackets, first. So 10 divided by 2 is 5. Okay. So we're going to bring our brackets down, and we have 5 times 8 plus 5, and we're still going to have minus 6 plus 10 to the third. Okay, so now we're still working with our bracket, and inside our bracket we have multiplication and addition. So multiplication comes before addition, so we'll do that. 5 times 8 is 40. And we have plus 5, we still have our bracket, and we have minus 6 plus 10 to the third power. Okay, now let's get rid of this bracket finally. So 40 plus 5 is 45, and we have minus 6 plus 10 to the third power. So we've taken care of parentheses. Now, outside the bracket, we're looking for exponents, and we do have exponents. So 10 to the third power is 10 times 10 times 10, which is 1,000. So we have plus, still have all this. Okay, so we took care of exponents. So now we have, looking for multiplication or division, there is none, so that's taken care of. Now we're looking for addition or subtraction from left to right. In this case, subtraction comes first. So 45 minus 6 is 39 plus 1,000. And of course, that would be 1,039 as our final simplified expression. Okay, Thanks for watching. If you would like to, subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, hit the like button. Thank you, and we'll see you on the next video.